friends, today I am going to explain you IELTS Academic Task 1. It's about the infographic. So I would like to explain you what infographic means. It's about information from the graph. Now graph can be anything like bar graph, pie charts, tables. And this task includes you have to write 150 words. At least 150 words does not mean you have to write only 150 words. You can write 170 to 190 words so that you can score more. Alright friends, now I would like to tell what information to look out. We are having three parts over here. The very first is introduction, the second is body or content, and the third one is end. In introduction part, you just have to write two to three lines. And it is given in the exam only, like the graph illustrates or graph shows about the two countries' population, that is China or India. And in this you don't have to elaborate so much, you just have to write the two to three lines, that's it. Now I'll explain you the second part, that is the body or content. In this you have to explain the facts and figures given in the table or the chart. First of all, you can explain about the axis, the y-axis, the x-axis, what is given in this. So you have to explain the whole of the thing. The second is the trends. Trends can be upward or downwards. If the population of China is going upward, you have to say like the trend is going upward. The third one is peak and the valley. Peak is the highest point and the valley is the lowest point. So you have to explain if there is certain point where the population is at the peak. So you have to explain in this year the population of China or India was at the peak or at the valley. The next one is stability or constant. So many a times what happens is like the information is given that is constant or which is stable. So you can explain it like the population of India and China in this year was constant or stable. Many a times what happens is the information given is increasing or decreasing. Like if I'm explaining you about the population, so in this year the population was increasing or decreasing or declining. So in this, what you can do is you can split this paragraph into two if the information is given in large, so that you can score more. And the last part of task one is end part. Here you need not give any opinions of your own, no conclusion can be there because it's all about the facts and figures. So you can compare here, like the population of India comparative to China, this year was this much and this year was this much. You need not give any opinions by your own because it's not about asking for your opinions or your conclusions. It's just about the facts and the figures. Thank you. I'll come with more videos very soon. For more updates, subscribe our channel, IELTS Learning.